Hi, if you are interested to take your data presentations and your data storytelling to the next level, you have clicked on the right video. Here I'll be showing you the top 5 advanced visualization techniques which will make that happen. Welcome to the channel Data Science Demonstrated. My name is Pranay and in this channel you will see how data science looks like using demonstrations but without going into complex programming screens. So whatever your profession, you can sit back, relax and enjoy the videos. The top 5 techniques which I'll be demonstrating you are shown right now on the screen. Now, these visualizations are a perfect balance between super visual effects and powerful data insights. I'll be demonstrating them using IMDb, which is the world's most popular movie database. So friends, grab a popcorn, take a comfortable seat and let's get started. But before that, do not forget to subscribe to the channel, like and comment on the video. Before we go into the arc diagram, here is a glimpse of how the movie data looks like. It has got various informations ranging from the movie title, the movie director, and right up to the revenue and the ratings. Now, if you look closely at the field category, you can see that one movie can be classified into multiple categories. Now, let me show you on how arc diagram can be extremely useful when you have multiple data which is packed into a single field. So here is how the arc diagram looks like. Now, because we are talking about movies, let me give you the cinema experience by switching to dark mode. As you can see that the arc diagram has got an awesome visual appeal. It really looks like a futuristic spaceship. The bubbles at the bottom of the visualization represent a movie category. And the arc is a connection between the categories. So for example, if I place my cursor over the category such as sci-fi, all the arcs with a connecting category are highlighted. Now this really looks visually stunning and it also gives lots of insights. So for example, you can use it to identify some rare films. And here I see that there is a connection between sci-fi and sports, which is a very rare combination. And one such example of a film which is sci-fi as well as sports is Real Steel. It is a film about robot boxing and if you have not seen it, I would highly recommend that you should see it. So as you can see that the arc diagram is really a good balance between super visual effects and exciting data insights. Let us now talk about the Sunburst and the Radial Tree visualization, which are very useful for hierarchy kind of data. If you look at the movie data, the country and the director can be thought of as a hierarchy. So I will use these two fields in addition to the revenue field to illustrate the Sunburst and the Radial Tree visualization. Here is a Sunburst visualization. Data is organized in a hierarchy way. So you have the countries and then you have the directors which belong to this country. And the size of the slice depends upon how much revenue the films of these directors are earning worldwide. As you can see that US and UK that dominate the movie market. And because of this, the directors from these countries, they occupy most of the space on this Sunburst visualization. And for this reason also, the directors from other countries such as Canada, China, France, India and Japan, they do not have a lot of space on this visualization. Now let us solve this problem using the radial tree visualization because we want to give equal importance to the directors also from these countries who are really making some great films. So here is the radial tree visualization. The radial tree has got a root and then it has got the country and then it has got the directors from this country. The color of the bubble represents the revenue which is earned by this director. More darker red is the color, more is the revenue earned by the director. You can also see that the directors from the countries such as Canada, China, France, and India and Japan are also very well represented in this visualization. So Radial Tree is really a stunning visualization. But it also helps to pack a lot of information in one single visual. Let us now move into a very interesting visualization called the network visualization. As the name suggests, it is very useful to understand the network and relations within the data. And let me illustrate this with the data on directors and actors. We will try to use this visualization to find out what kind of relations and network which exists between actors and directors. So here is the network visualization. Once again, it really looks very stunning. It looks like as if spaceships are engaged in some kind of intergalactic war. In this network graph, you will see some clusters. And the center of the cluster corresponds to the directors. So for example, this cluster corresponds to the director Christopher Nolan. And when you zoom into it, you will see the actors with which Christopher Nolan works with. So for example, you see actors such as Leonardo DiCaprio and Heath Ledger, as these two have worked with Christopher Nolan for the film Inception and Batman. Now the formation of these clusters also signifies that most of the actors, they prefer working with one director. And there are very few actors who work across multiple directors. And such actors are shown as connections between the two clusters. So for example, if we can take this connection over here, Matt Damon. Matt Damon is a connection between two clusters, which signifies that Matt Damon has been working with multiple directors. So Matt Damon has worked with Steven Spielberg, as well as he has worked with Martin Scorsese. And this corresponds to the movies Saving Private Ryan and Departed. So this is a really interesting visual, and it gives lots of insight into how the movie industry works. Alright my friends, let's now move into a very interesting visualization called the Swimlane Image. Now here you see three swimlanes. The first one corresponds to Steven Spielberg, the second one corresponds to Christopher Nolan, and the third one corresponds to Ridley Scott. Now each of these boxes, they represent a film. So for example, Christopher Nolan, he started with the film Following. Later on he made Memento, followed by Insomnia. And the last film which he made was Tenet. Now you can enhance this visualization by using images. Let me show you by hovering over the film of Spielberg. Now here you see the name of the film, but you also see a corresponding image. So for example, Spielberg, he started with the film Sugarland Express, and then he moved to Jaws, and then he made the film Close Encounter of the Third Kind. So as you can see that this technique of combining data and images is really powerful and helps a lot in data storytelling. Now images could be anything. They could be product photos, for example. Images also help your audience relate to the data. So for your next data storytelling presentation, try to combine data with images, which will completely submerge your audience and make them relate to the data. Let's now end with the climax with this racing bar chart. This visualization alone is telling you 50 years of film history. You see the year which is increasing, and you see the category of films which are doing most of the business in that year. So for example, in the early 80s, you had the films of adventures and actions which were dominating the box office. And then you saw the rise of sci-fi films with the films such as Terminator and Aliens, which took the box office by storm. And then you saw the rise of action comedy films, mostly featuring actors like Jim Carrey and Jackie Chan. This action comedy films stayed on the top for quite a while. And then in the mid 90s, something happened. In the mid 90s, you saw the rise of drama films, mainly driven by the films such as Apollo 13 and Titanic, which really took the box office once again by surprise and storm. So as you can see that this racing bar chart can help you really tell a very compelling story, as well as make your audience submerge into very superb visual effects.